Hi everyone. So we continue memorizing from the book of Hebrews. So we memorized up to verse 8. Today we are going to memorize verse 9. I'll read that first. Hebrews chapter 2, verse 9. But we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. So this is slightly longer compared to the other verses. So I'll try to recall it. But we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for all. Death for everyone. Okay, small mistake only. So I'll read that again. But we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. So we already meditated on this. The verse 7, which is taken from Psalm 8, it's the same verse, right? You made him for a little while lower than the angels. You have crowned him with glory and honor. So that is what is given in verse 7. So here, he has taken that and applied it to Jesus Christ. So verse 7 can be applied to anyone, right? But he has applied it to Jesus Christ because he is the example of a perfect man. He is the perfect man, right? So that is why the author has applied it to Jesus Christ. And he is saying, but we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of suffering of death, so that by the grace of God, he might taste death for everyone. So when we meditated on verse 7, we meditated, right? So when we meditated on all of this. So, but we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels. So humans are considered lower than angels, and Christ, with respect to his human nature, he is inferior to angels because he as a God is not inferior, but he took the form of human, right? He became human. So he was 100% human and 100% God. So in his humanity, he was little less than the angels. So that is what we see here, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death. So when we meditated on verse 7, we meditated from Psalm 45, where we see God's glory, his majesty. We see Jesus as a king. And at the same time, we meditated from Isaiah 53, where we see the suffering servant, right? So how he has obtained that glory? Through his suffering and death. So we can go back and meditate on Isaiah 53, because I want to keep the reflection short. I'm not going back and reading that, but you can go back to 53 and meditate on Christ's passion there. So, but we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. So the word he used is taste death for everyone, as if he is savoring that, right? So the chalice he was sipping, he was drinking it sip by sip, right? He was sipping and having that, right? So we can imagine his agony in the Garden of Gethsemane, his intense passion in Gethsemane. So we can imagine all of that. So one thing we have to keep in mind is, God didn't have to do all this, right? He didn't have to come down as human. But out of love, he has come down. He has humbled himself, right? Willingly, he has humbled himself. Willingly, he has taken up that passion, right? Out of love for me and you, right? So that's something we should meditate in our heart, and we should try to reciprocate that love or return that love. So here the word he used is, he might taste death, right? So as if he is savoring that, right? He willingly accepted it. So that's what I wanted to meditate on this. Sorry, that's what I wanted to tell you. But we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God he might taste death for everyone. So one more thing I wanted to tell about cross also, because after Jesus' passion, cross is no longer a symbol of shame or disgrace, right? So it's a symbol of Christ's passion. By virtue of Christ's passion, the cross is no longer an ignominious scaffold. It is a glorious throne. Tradition attributes to Saint Andrew the Apostle these words in praise of the cross on which he was going to die. O goodly cross, glorified by the limbs of our Lord. O cross, so long desired, so ardently loved, so tirelessly sought, and now offered to me. Take me to my Master, so that he who redeemed me through thee may welcome me through thee. So just think about the intense love that Saint Andrew had towards Jesus, right? So we should all aspire for that. So with that, we'll conclude today's meditation. I'll just read that again. But we see Jesus, who for a little while was made lower than the angels, crowned with glory and honor because of the suffering of death, so that by the grace of God, he might taste death for everyone. Thank you. God bless you all.